Coronavirus disease prevention and treatment. Hand hygiene is the first and most important line of defense. Like cold and flu bugs, the new virus is spread via droplets when a person coughs or sneezes. The droplets land on surfaces and are picked up on the hands of others and spread further. People catch the virus when they touch their infected hands to their mouth, nose, or eyes. It follows that the single most important thing you can do to protect yourself is to keep your hands clean by washing them frequently with soap and water or a hand sanitizing gel. Also, try to avoid touching your mouth, nose, or eyes with unwashed hands, something we all do unconsciously on average about 15 times an hour. More than 80 clinical trials launched to test coronavirus treatments. As HIV drugs, stem cells, and traditional Chinese medicines vie for a chance to prove their worth, the World Health Organization attempts to bring order to the search. Please tell us how the outbreak has had an impact on you. Tick all that apply. Two medical personnel check on the conditions of a patient with COVID-19 in Jinyantan Hospital. Medics check on people with COVID-19 in Jinyantan Hospital in Wuhan, China. Credit, feature China, Barcroft Media via Getty. China has more than 80 running or pending clinical trials on potential treatments for COVID-19, the illness caused by a coronavirus that has thus far killed nearly 1,400 people and infected more than 48,000 across China. New pharmaceutical drugs are listed beside thousand-year-old traditional therapies in a public registry of China's clinical trials, which is growing every day. There is no known cure, and doctors are eager to help those with the disease, but scientists caution that only carefully conducted trials will determine which measures work. I am personally affected, you have it, a family member or someone you know has it. It has affected my travel to conferences or other work. I have changed the scope of my research to study the outbreak or the virus. It has affected supplies of lab equipment, reagents or other items I use for work. It has affected my research in other ways. I have not been affected by the outbreak. Other tips include: carry a hand sanitizer with you to make frequent cleaning of hands easy. Always wash your hands before you eat. Be especially careful in busy airports and other public transport systems about touching things and then touching your face. Carry disposable tissues with you. Cover your nose and mouth when you cough or sneeze and dispose of the tissue carefully. Catch it, bin it, kill it. Do not share snacks from packets or bowls that others are dipping their fingers into. Avoid shaking hands or cheek kissing if you suspect viruses are circulating. Regularly clean, not just your hands, but commonly used surfaces and devices you touch or handle. Is it just droplets from the nose and mouth that spread the new virus? Probably not, but they are by far the most common risk. The NHS is advising doctors that the virus is also likely to be contained in other bodily secretions, including in blood, feces, and urine. Here again, hand and surface hygiene is the key. How can I protect my family, especially children? Children are a major vector for the spread of droplet-based viruses because they interact physically so much with each other and are not the best at keeping themselves clean. However, you can greatly lower the risk that children pose of spreading or catching viruses by explaining to them how germs spread and the importance of good hand and face hygiene, keeping household surfaces clean, especially kitchens, bathrooms, and door handles, using clean cloths to wipe surfaces, so you don't transfer germs from one surface to another, giving everyone their own towel and making sure they know not to share toothbrushes, etc. Keep your home dry and airy. Bugs thrive in musty environments. What about face masks? Do they work? Paper face masks are not generally recommended by the NHS for ordinary citizens, with good reason. They are ill-fitting and what protection they might initially provide soon expires. Worse, they quickly become moist inside, providing the perfect environment for germs to thrive in. They also become a hazard for others if carelessly discarded. However, an exception to this would be if you were displaying symptoms such as coughing or sneezing, then a mask may help prevent you spreading the virus to others in busy locations. In hospitals, healthcare workers treating patients with the virus will wear masks, but these are specialist devices and there are strict protocols they must follow to ensure they remain safe and effective. Can the new coronavirus be treated? There is no simple cure for the new coronavirus, just as there is no cure for the common cold. In more severe cases, the virus causes pneumonia, an infection that inflames the lungs and causes breathing difficulty. This is where the main danger lies. Viral pneumonia cannot be treated with antibiotics and, for the moment at least, there are no antivirals specific to this particular virus. Instead, doctors focus on supporting patients' lung function as best they can. They may be given oxygen or placed on a breathing machine, ventilator, in the most severe cases. Other symptoms such as fever and discomfort will be treated using drugs such as aspirin and ibuprofen. Secondary infections may be treated with antibiotics. Are some groups of people more at risk than others? Data from China suggests that people of all ages are at risk of contracting the virus. However, as with most respiratory illnesses, it is likely to be the young and old who are most at risk once infected. People with a reduced chance of surviving pneumonia include those over age 65, children under the age of 2, people with underlying health conditions or a weakened immune system. Of the first 425 confirmed deaths across mainland China, 80% of victims were over the age of 60, and 75% had some form of underlying disease. Two-thirds of the confirmed deaths were male. Is there a vaccine for the new coronavirus? There is currently no vaccine, but scientists around the world are racing to produce one, thanks to China's prompt sharing of the virus's genetic code. However, any potential vaccine will not be available for up to a year and would most likely be given to health workers most at risk of contracting the virus first. For now, it is a case of containment and increasing hospital capacity to treat patients. China has thrown up several new 1,000-bed hospitals in the last month alone. Capacity to treat patients who require both ventilation and isolation will also be a major challenge for the NHS if the virus takes hold in the UK, but that has not happened yet.